And remember that we have still many, many skaters to come, including Elvis Stoiko, including Kurt Browning, who has drawn last place to skate. Still four groups of five men to skate. The next group waiting to take the ice for warm-up. And every one of these skaters is wondering, uh-oh, is this the night when we crash and burn? Sometimes competitions go like that.
Exactly, and you have to, I mean, for all of them, actually, you know what, it's a chance for them to say, you know, some of the best guys in the world this is happening to, and you have to reevaluate and just and focus. That is really the key for all of these guys, particularly Kurt and Elvis, to not be you know, bothered or concerned with this.
On the ice, representing Estonia, Margus Herdi.
The delay is just as we await the announcement for the next group of skaters to take the ice. And we're all sitting here watching the crowd as they discuss what has ever happened. Who knows? The pressure of sometimes unexplainable events. Certainly when a skater has an accident that involves their equipment, it becomes naturally number one priority. And then when the routine gets confused for the next skater up, Victor almost didn't have time to reassess the situation. He was pushed out onto the ice, and all of the time wondering, is there something on the ice that's going to get in my way?
In hindsight, you know, maybe what he should have done was actually move away from the situation, go backstage again, and come back out as if it was his turn and there were no other disruptions. He stood by the boards and he watched, and he came on the ice early while the young girls were picking up the screws, and that's not normal.
No.
And you can't prepare for that. And he wasn't prepared for that. And I would think that's what the problem was.
And that's certainly not the kind of situation that you ever simulate either. You don't expect that anyone's going to have problems with their blade. Now, here is the real cause of the delay. The young competitor from Estonia, Margus Hernits, who lost his blade, at least the front part of his blade, during the performance, gives you some idea about the kind of pressure the blade and boot must take during the picking for triple jumps. So here we go. Margus is going to try it again right from the top.
You know, with his age being so young, and people, I mean, all of us felt sorry for him. He was having some big problems out there. Now he's a crowd favorite. Everybody wants him to skate well. Here we get to see the triplets for the second time. Much better than the first attempt. And there's the double axel. Not too often you get a second attempt at your short program, and I'm sure Victor would love another attempt as well. You know, it's funny, this time around with the program, he's actually changed it around because the triple toe loop, which was just a double that we just saw, was at the other end the first time around.
gives you some idea about the confusion that enters a competitor's mind when a disaster strikes. Much better performance this time round.
This is the triple S. This was the jump that happened on with the screws coming up, because there's so much torque involved when you're taking off. This is the double axle, much better.
The next group may take the ice for the six.
Not quite the quality of some of the others. And the double toe loop.
But he got the job done. Came back. I worried all through it whether the blade was going to pop off again. Once the boot goes, it goes.
And those and the holes become stripped. I mean, it takes some fancy footwork to get that fixed.
Required elements marks, though, way down in the mid-3 range. 1.2.8 from the French judge.
4,2, 4,5.
Presentation marks for Margus Hermits. Still fairly low. He's got some growing to do. And he is 5th out of 5 at the moment in the men's technical competition.
4,3, 4,1, 4,8, 4,2, 4,3, 4,1, 4,3. Thank you.
And now, Rod, give us some stand.